Goggles and gogglets and everything else. See, pay attention. Behave yourselves. Do, you know, look busy. Right. Hello, ladies and germlines, boys and girls. And we're on one already. Already started. I've already started squeaking the chair, trying to disguise me blowing off in it. Shall I get on with it? We've got... Put your rings on, boy. Look, you've got my rings on the side here. What's the matter with me? I've got a bit of a special one. I do not know how to pronounce this. Well, I tried typing this before on my phone and it came up. What was it? Something braggy slig or something like that. But anyway, it's I'll try that. Look, Iraq. Rakslee. Now, let's see what it says on the thing, because I don't know nothing about it. And as usual, in my aim to not get taste notes and things like that, especially with kind of important beers like these, isn't it? I don't want to get too many taste notes now. I don't want to get led along by the nose, you know, by a ring on the nose, to what I should be smelling and tasting in it. So... I don't think I've had the whiskey, Glenfarclas. I've had a lot of different ones and everything else, but I don't think I've had that one. Anyway, it means golden nectar and is so named because of its vibrant amber colour and rich finish. This limited release has been matured in casks from 175-year-old Glenfarclas distillery, to add complementary whiskey notes, to which is already an amazing brew. Now, I think we're talking what's their lager called? Because this is a lager, I believe. No, it says ale matured in whiskey casks. Well, I could be wrong. I was pretty sure that it was their lager, their... God, blimey, my brain's gone dead. I'll think of it in a minute. It is elegant, crisp, and as in... Whoa, don't read the things. Colour, nose, and everything else it will tell you there. Since 1865, Glenfarclas, blah, 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 blah. Right, I won't read the rest of that. But basically, single malt, single Highland malt whiskey, in the traditional Speyside style. All right. Here you go. Lovely jubbly. So we've got a little posh little thing on the top. We've got a little label and everything else. And I thought this was a lager. I thought it was. I'm pretty sure it's a lager. I'm sure it is. Well, who knows? There's a bit of barley, bit of wheat, bit of all sorts of stuff. Bottle conditioning, I am not sure about. I can't see anything. Looks as clear as glorious sunshine. I'm going to have to use... I can't find the thingy, so I'm going to have to use the little jobby on the end here. Always bends the doodars out of me lids and things like that, so excuse me for a minute. Let's get the foil off. There we go. Raise the old skirts up. Bit sticky, big sticky bit round the edge. Come on, up you come. Right, there we go. And on there it's got little Harvey the mouse, little Harvey, the old fieldy mouse. Let's get this open. There we go. Right, ring back on. And there's Harvey the mouse there underneath the foil, keeping him nice and fresh. I don't know if the foil actually does anything. I think it's just a posh thing. It makes it look nice and sexy and everything. So that's going in my GBBF glass, Great British Beer Festival. Because for the moment, Scotland is still British. I ain't going to get into that. Less said the better. So let's pour it out. I don't think we're holding any yeast back at all. So straight in there. Ooh, just hold the last touch. Just in case. Oh, it smells lovely. Really smells nice. Getting like little fruity edges in there. Little tiny hints of something grapey. You're getting a bit of kind of appley notes in there. You're getting nice little a hint of like a little sherry background note there. I've got a wet nose. Let's have a twirl, gentle twirl, because I'm a bit near the top. I think we've poured a bit extra than what I was thinking I was going to. Now, let's have a little quick look at the colour. Have I got anything white to hold up behind it? Probably not. What's that? Oh, I don't know if I want to get that out. Da 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 do 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 do. Something white would be nice. Out of the book here. Page out of the book. Here we go. Look at that. Isn't it nice? Let's just twirl the head back in again. Just thrown some on the floor. Barflies are going, wee-hee! Little bit of head, just holding on gently and everything, doing its thing. And lovely jubbly. Nice citrusy notes and everything else in there, as I said. You've got grapey notes as well. And something like a little distant sherry note in there. You're getting a tiny little vanilla edge. And you are getting a little hint, a tiny, tiny hint, subtle hint of whiskey in there as well. But it's so subtle, you can't really grab hold of it properly. Smells really fresh and refreshing. Nice light notes, nice light biscuity notes on there as well. So let's dive in. Cheers, everyone. Sláinte. Cheers. That is really glorious. Oh, that is lovely. Oh, that is really nice. Right. This is an unusual thing because you kind of usually you're expecting the whiskies to come in and be really boisterous in a drink. Really kind of rah, rah, and all that and come in there and you expect... You kind of would expect a big porter or a big, you know, stout or something like that to be in there with them. In order that they don't get overtaken by a big party crasher and that, you know. This is it's got a real delicate little dance going on, a little delicate ballet on the senses and that. A nice little delicate ballet. You don't really get the aromas that much. You get nice little, like as I say, nice little crisp, perky aromas. You get a ballet on the tongue. You get a nice vanilla coating, like an oily coating on the tongue. You get those little bitter fruits in there, and they're kind of hanging on. And they're a long, long finish. But hanging on with them is a nice little ashy, oaky, smoky little edge in there. And it's a little whiskey, notey edge in there. And it's just hanging on, and it's kind of hanging, but it's not got talons going in the tongue and ripping everything else out. You've still got a nice little delicate sweetness, but without it being cloying and bleh, you know. It tastes really refreshing. A little bit like a kind of a Bock lager, like a Bock, you know, boom. Nut, get that job, you know, like little goatee job. You know, kind of strong tasting lager. Not overpowerful, but it's got a nice punchy taste to it. We're talking 6 on the Richter scale on the old ABV. 6%, so it's kind of a nice sort of semi-strong lager. But that is really, it's really well balanced. And I think that that shows, something like that really shows skill. A lot of skill in brewing. Because, you know, brewing's an art and everything. And it's very kind of, well, not very, very easy, but it's fairly easy to just get a load of Citra and a load of Amarillo and a load of Galaxy and a load of Summit and things, and big sort of punchy, big sort of hops in there, and just pile them in there and go, "Wee, get hold of that," something nice and sweet to back them up sort of thing, and you just pile loads of stuff in. It's kind of, it's not skilled, it's still nice. You get those big resin-rich beers that are hops and roar, and they're really nice, but it's not art, you know. It's really fantastic and really delicious and everything else, but it's not artistic, you know. And this is a balance, is a beautiful ballet of symphony of flavors that are just so well balanced, really lovely, delicate flavors. And you have to be a connoisseur like me in order to appreciate. There you go. No, so I'm all wet now. No, seriously though, it's one of those that you want to take time with, and you want to sit and just take your time and have a little wander, a little kind of wander through your mind and your memories and things. Let a beer, a good beer, let it speak to you. Let it kind of get into those, because you've got memories hooked onto little aromas and little flavors and things. Now, as I say, the aromas, you're not getting you're getting like nice perky little aromas, little fruity ones. But the main thing in this, I think, is the flavors, the tastes. Pardon me. Yeah, the palate on this is just yum 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 yum. It's, you know, really. Start, you suddenly, your mind's all over the place, you know. Let it have a wash around. Let it paint the gob, and let it paint the insides of your mouth and that. Around the cheeks, you get a different feel, you get a different flavour. Across the palate, across the tongue and everything, you get a different flavour. As you swallow, it comes up the back of the nose and swirls around inside the old bugle and that. You've got the olfactory system. It's as big as your fist. And it's in the middle of your head, just behind here. And goes up behind your eyes and everything else. It's massive in there. It all swirls around. So have a breathe as you're going. Get a mouthful. Get a few swallows first, though. So it's going down. Get a big mouthful, swirl. Swallow that. And then as you breathe out, breathe out a little bit through your nose and through your mouth. So, you know, like that. You get a lot going on then. Ooh, that's lovely. Yeah, that's nice. Nice, delicate little kind of tangerine-y background notes. Little tiny ones, though. Little kind of very ripe tangerines. Getting little hints of lemongrass there. And a tiny little hint of something spicy as well in there. That I can't place. Something coriander-like or something like that. Coriander seeds or something, you know. As you kind of cook them up on the frying pan, and they'll go pick, 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 shooting at you, innit? If you're crazy like me, don't bother like kind of getting the missile and porter out, you know. pistle and mortar. So don't bother getting that out, you know. Just chuck them in there. Put a lid over. Right, sorry, I've gone off. Oh, that's nice. Right, listen, enough of that. I'm going to sit and enjoy the rest of that. If I don't drop it on the floor. So you guys out there, guys and dolls and everything out there, have a look for that one. Go and try it, buy it and like it, because that is lovely. Get one, sit down, take your time with it, really take your time with it, and just prove to yourself that you can live like a king. You can actually live like a king. So get one of those, sit down, don't have food with it. I mean, there will be kind of your experts and things that will go, right, you want to have it with this food and that food and all that business, which is good, because there's some beers that really go fantastic with food. Don't have a chaser with it, because, you know, thinking, oh, you know, it's got whiskey sort of thing, it's got to have a chaser with it. Don't have a chaser with it, just have it on its own. Sit there, get everyone out the bloody household and sit there. Pick it around in your brain, innit? That there, bum, 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 bum. Try it, buy it, and love it. Lovely stuff. Slodgy, see you soon. See you in the next one. Don't. And what I talk with my hands, don't I? Don't be late. I'll start without you. Bye.